Thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you. We thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord. Hallelujah. For his word to be praised. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. We thank you for the word of God. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord Jesus. Amen. 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 Today I want to talk about, amen, a evangelist, amen, by the name of George Mueller. George Mueller was a Christian evangelist and the director of the Ashley Down Orphanage in Bristol, England. He cared for about 10,024 orphans during his lifetime and provided educational opportunities for the orphans to the point that he was even accused by some as raising the poor above the natural station in British life. He established 117 schools, which he offered Christian education to more than 120,000 children. After his death, amen, his personal journal revealed more than 50,000 entries of answered prayers. Amen. When he asked the secret behind the dramatic result of his prayers, he confided that for over 60 years, he had never petitioned God. Listen, he had never petitioned God without appropriate scriptures to match his request. Hallelujah. So in essence, whenever he had a problem, he found a scripture to match it. And when he began to pray, he began to petition God according to his word. Why? Because the word of God cannot lie. Oh my God. And because the word can't lie, he found an effective manner in which to get answers to his prayers. Which was, anytime he had a situation, let's say he had sickness in his body, he would find, amen, a scripture that by his stripes I am healed. Come on, Zion. Everything that was going on in his life, he began to petition God according to his word. So what that confirms to me is that for every situation, I must find a scripture to match it and put scripture word concerning the matter. When we look at Proverbs 15:8, it says the prayer of the upright pleases God. Amen. So it is God's delight, amen, for me to pray to him, for me to have communication with him. And then Proverbs 15:9, it says, but the Lord, I love those who pursue righteousness, those that pursue holiness. It is the Lord loves them. Amen. But in this life, we get in a hurry.
Amen.
We must learn to wait on God.
Yes.
Amen. Can you think of a few things that you went ahead of God on? I don't know about you, but I can think of a lot of things that I walked out of timing on. Amen. It might have been God, but I didn't walk in the season of God. Y'all ain't talking to me. Amen. When we look at Proverbs, when we look at the Psalms, amen, the 46th division in the 12th verse, it says, be still and know that I am God.
Amen. Amen.
We have to learn to allow our flesh. We have to learn to not allow our flesh to allow us to get in a hurry. Y'all ain't talking to me. When we look at Psalms 46, amen, the 46th division of Psalms, it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Y'all ain't talking to me. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling of the swelling thereof, Selah, there is a river, their streams wherefore shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. Our God is in our midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her and the upright early. My God, the sixth verse says the heathen rage, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The seventh verse says the Lord of hosts is with us. I'm going to stop right there. Amen. When we look at, amen, amen, the 46th division of Psalms, in the first verse we see God is. When we look at the 10th verse, it says, God is. Hallelujah. When we look at the 7th verse, it says, the Lord of hosts is. Y'all ain't talking. And when we look at the 11th verse, it says, the Lord of hosts is. We continue to see that God is. What is he? He is a present help in the time of trouble. And no matter what I'm going through, God is. All you want to open up your mouth and say, God is. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He is God.
Yes.
God. And when we look at the 10th verse, I'm still in Psalms 46. It says, be still.
Yeah.
I'm going to say, be still. Be still and know that I am God. Hallelujah. Yeah. I will be exalted among the heathen, and I will be exalted in the earth.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He says, be still. Somebody right now, you need to know to be still. Huh?
Yeah.
I don't know what you're going through. Huh? I don't know what it looks like and what it sounds like. Huh? I don't know what you face against. Huh? But come tonight to tell you to be still. Huh? And you know that God is with you. Huh? He'll never leave you alone when he's the Savior. Huh? He's still on the throne. Huh? You ought to say, he's still there. He's still there. Huh? He's still there. He's still there. Huh?
I'm
sure to say, he's still and know. Huh? He's still and know that God is God. Huh? Don't get in a hurry. Huh? Don't get in a hurry. Huh? Don't get in a hurry. Huh? Don't go before him. Don't go after him. Don't in the timing of God, the seasons of God. Huh? Be still and know that God. God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
It takes skills to learn to listen.
Amen.
We easy to talk, but so to listen. Come on, God. Amen. It takes skill to be a listener. You know, we have to pray, God, give me a listening ear that I can hear what people are saying. Give me the skill of discernment that even I can discern, amen, what they're not even saying. Y'all ain't talking to me. So it takes skill.
Amen.
To hear the voice of God. Because you gotta train yourself to be quiet. God, is this you? Is this me? Is this somebody else? Whose opinion? What's being said? What is it? Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. When I begin to research today and begin to prepare for the message, amen, I begin to look at Hezekiah. When we go to 2 Kings 18 and 13, amen, we see Hezekiah's back was against the wall. Y'all been talking to me.
Yeah.
He was in the midst of something and he needed God's help. That trouble was all around him. In 2 Kings 18 and 13, it says, now in the 14th year of the king Hezekiah, did, amen, the Syrian king of Assyria come up against all the 10 cities of Judea, and he took them. So there was a king, another king that came up against Judea. Hallelujah. And he began to attack them. He began to seize the cities. When we look at 2 Kings 19 and 1, oh my God. It says, and it came to pass when King Hezekiah heard it, that he ripped his clothes and covered himself with sackcloth, and he went into the house of the Lord. And he sent Eliakim, which was over the household of Shebnah, the scribe and the elders and the priests, covered with sackcloth to his son Isaiah. He took him to Isaiah, amen, the prophet, the son of Amos, amen. And they said to him, thus said Hezekiah. So they went to Isaiah and they began to say, this is what Hezekiah is saying. This is the word. He said, this day of trouble and of rebuke and of blasphemy, for the children are come to birth and there is no strength of birth for her. Hezekiah recognizes that he's in trouble. He says, look at here. I'm worn out. The people are scared. We don't even have strength to fight. Y'all ain't talking to me. Have you ever been in a situation where you had no strength? God. When we look at the New Living Translation, they told him, this is what King Hezekiah says. Today is the day of trouble and insult and disgrace. It is like when a child is ready to be born, but the mother has no strength to deliver the baby. Hezekiah say, I'm worn out. The people are scared. I'm scared. Oh, but they don't have no strength. Look like the end is going to overtake us. The contemporary English version of this particular scripture says, these are difficult and disgraceful times. Our nation is like a woman too weak to give birth when it's time for her baby to born. Hezekiah is telling them, look at here, we are in trouble, my God. Hallelujah, the people are scared. I'm scared, amen. Almost about to give up. Oh my God. So the servants of King Hezekiah came to Isaiah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Amen. They said to him, oh God, This is what's going on. In 6 verses, it says, and Isaiah said unto them, thus shall ye say to your master, thus saith the Lord, be not afraid.
Yes.
Oh. Tell them, be still in thy word. Yes. Of the words which thou hast heard. Yes. See, Hezekiah heard.
Yes, it
what was going on?
Yeah.
He heard it in the next day and sent word to the prophet. Look at here. This is what's going on. The prophet sent word back to Hezekiah. And the prophet said, be not afraid. In other words, be still.
Yeah.
Don't be fooled by what you hear. Come on, Zion.
Amen.
Amen. He said, don't be not afraid of the words which thou hast heard.
Yeah.
Which the servant of the king of Assyria has blasphemed me. He said, look at here, God, and say, don't be scared about what you hear. I know he's blasphemed me and he said some words that are not true. But don't you be moved by what men are saying around you. I come tonight to tell you to be still and then be moved by what man is saying around you. Don't be moved by what's going on in the White House. After we serve a God that's over 45. We serve a God that's over. I shake it out of both sides. The United States of America. We serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Be not afraid about what's going on around you. It may look like we're losing, but I believe the God we serve will always show up on time. For he's a God that never late. He's always on time. Y'all ain't talking to me.
Hallelujah. Yes.
So we look here. See, the prophet sent the word back to Hezekiah. He said, hallelujah, be still. Don't be afraid about what's going on. Now it looks bad. It looks like you're going to lose the battle. Oh, but it's not the way it looks. Oh, it's not the way it looks. You ought to speak to the situation. Whatever you're going through, you ought to say it's not the way it looks. Who's the report that we believe tonight? You shall believe the report of the Lord. Don't be moved by what you see.
Amen.
Hallelujah. For some trust in horses and some trust in chariots. How about tonight we will trust in the name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And the righteous run therein and they are safe. You can't be moved by what you see. You can't be moved by what you hear. We'll be in a time where we only can trust the word of God. But his word shall not change. And I believe we serve a God that's going to show up on time. So Isaiah sent the word back to Hezekiah. He says, listen here. This is what the Lord is saying to you. Don't be moved by what you hear. Don't be afraid about what you see. But be still, my God. Hallelujah.
Listen,
now this is the 7th verse. God tell the prophet to tell him there, God, behold, I send a blast upon him, and he shall heal a wound, and shall return to his own land, and I will cause him to fall by the sword in his own land. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you that God is able. Hallelujah. Not your bullies. He's able to come against those that are fighting the Christians. Y'all ain't talking to me. He's able to handle those that blaspheme him, my God. He's able to handle those that are coming against. Hallelujah. The righteous seed of God. Y'all ain't talking to me.
Thank you.
God told Hezekiah.
Yeah.
Don't be moved by the bullies.
Amen.
Don't be moved by the bullies. There was a king coming up against him that was bullying him, telling him what he was going to do. And when we read that chapter in the 2 Kings 19, we see other people saying word to Hezekiah. Telling Hezekiah, Hezekiah, you think God going to save you and your people? I don't trust in your God. Hi, Hezekiah, I heard about what these what this king is doing. He's taking and possessing the land. You and your people going to be slaves. You and your people will be killed. Hezekiah had to stay focused. See, there are times that you got to hear from God for yourself. yourself, my God. Hallelujah. Other people might not believe God for your healing, but you got to believe it. Whose report will you believe tonight? You got to believe the report of the Lord. God said he's going to heal you. He's the same God that healed you before, and he's going to be the same God that healed you again. He's the same God that delivered you before, and he's the same God that's going to be delivering you again. You better trust in the word of God. Hezekiah was being bullied by a king. But Hezekiah didn't miss his bullying. He began to cry out to the Lord. He kept crying out for the word of God. Hezekiah began to say, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, hear my cry tonight. Hezekiah kept crying out to the Lord. Oh God, and you set me in, it's going to take me. Trouble is on this side of me, God. Trouble is on that side of me, God. They're sending messages that the Lord is going to stop. Hezekiah turned his face toward the wall and began to pray to his God. Tonight there's some things you're going to have to go to God for yourself. You have to turn your face to the wall. Hear God for yourself. Hallelujah. 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 When I was diagnosed with third stage cancer, oh God, oh God, it didn't look good, my God. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Oh God. They first diagnosed me, told me it was second stage cancer. When I went back again, they said the tumor had left the breast, and it had begun to climb up my lymph nodes. I said, with no signs and no symptoms, y'all ain't talking to me now. The cancer had left the breast, and it began to go up the lymph nodes. It begins to spread through the body. But the God I serve, I take it down the most high, was able to what captured it, amen, before it began to what spread throughout my body. Y'all ain't talking to me. Hallelujah. So they told me one day it was second stage cancer. The next day, the third stage cancer. I said, oh God, I begin to shake my face before the Lord. I said, Lord, have mercy. I begin to cry out to the Lord. Say, God, my daughter needs me. She's too young to be without me. My brother and his four children need me. Oh God, my family needs me. I can't go. I begin to set my face towards the Lord and begin to cry out. And I heard the Lord say, this sickness is not unto death. Hallelujah. 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 When I got the revelation that I will go down on the Lord, regardless of what the report said by me, by the doctors, I begin to, oh, get up and dry my tears. I begin to walk in that hospital. And still have faith in God. I begin to say, God, they can come this body, but they cannot have my life. Y'all ain't talking to me. So I rolled in there the first surgeon, third, fourth, and fifth. I would lay up there because I knew they couldn't take my life. I knew I was in the hand of God. And tonight, no matter what your situation may be, your situation may not be in your health. It may be in your finances. It may be in your children. You may got a negative report from the North, East, South, and West. But tonight I hear the Lord say, be still. Be still and know. Be still and know tonight that God is God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
And see, I want you to understand that the enemy has tactics. Amen.
You,
I believe it was in May. Amen.
Thank
we were getting
you.
Ready to go to
Jesus.
Africa.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
And right when we got ready to go, it looked like all kind of things was coming at me. Amen. One of the things that came at me that shook me was the federal income tax, that filed the income tax. And IRS, right when I got ready to go, sent me a letter saying I owed them $1,600. Okay. All right. Then, right, the same week, we got another letter saying that my insurance was canceled through my health insurance. And I'm like, oh God. Then I got another letter about another situation. As these situations were coming to me, the enemy tried to shake me. Like, how are you going to go and go to Africa and go here and go there, and you have these things here. But at each one, I opened and read it, I heard the Lord say, be still. It's going to work out. It's going to work out.
Amen.
When I finally got that coming, I noticed that it did come when I didn't have any engagements. These things came right when I was getting ready to go on an international trip.
Amen.
Amen. We had just got back from Japan in February. Boom, now May, 3 months later, we're ready to go back. The team and I are ready to go back to another international country and preach. I think we were gone like 10 days. So right when I'm getting ready to go do the work of the Lord, I get a letter that shakes me. You know, you get a letter from the IRS that you owe them. My goodness, that kind of shakes you, kind of puts fear in you.
Amen.
They want to take your property and everything else. So, to make a long story short about that situation, when I came back, I kept working with it, kept working with it to get it resolved. And in the end, they owe me $600. See, that situation came to what shaked me.
Amen.
And it really could have messed up the whole trip, my attitude, my mind, everything. But I had to leave it in the hands of God and still be still and know.
Amen.
Come on, Zion.
Amen.
When I got the health insurance paper, said, this is still, so you're going to have to petition and get it,
To get the case reversed,
you're going to have to petition them, appeal it. That's the word I'm looking for. You're going to have to appeal it. I said, okay, so I appealed it. Amen. So that's in the situation. And submitted the documents. That situation is being reversed. Amen. All this came at me when I'm getting ready to go out of the country. Health insurance, taxes, this, that. It flooded me. And I had to stay focused on what God was saying, which was, be still, it's going to work out. Don't focus on that right now. Go do your trip, and when you come back, you can deal with it. There are situations in your life you're just not going to have. You're going to have to put it on pause. Y'all been talking to me. You're going to have to take that situation. Put it on pause. God, you handle it, and I'm going to do your work. And God, you work it, and you give me strategies on how to get this situation resolved. And I'm going to trust you. Amen. And I'm going to trust you. IRS went as far as sending us a letter saying they were going to take my home for $1,600, and they were going to take the home. Amen. And then when I called them to get the situation resolved, oh, it was a mistake. I'm still waiting on the letter for the mistake. Y'all, I didn't trust them. I said, no, we got to work this out. You can't take my property over $1,600, my goodness.
Amen.
But you know, God resolved that. But see, that came as a distraction.
Amen.
Hezekiah was getting worried about what was being about to happen, and the enemy kept distracting him. He kept going to God. He kept going to God. God kept telling him, this is what I'm going to do. Don't be worried about your bullets. Many of you, there are spiritual giants that are coming and attacking your mind. There are situations that's coming against your mind, and you're going to have to tell it peace. You're going to have to learn to pull down every bank and evil and wicked imagination that comes to exalt itself against the knowledge of God, that comes to get you outside the will of God.
Amen.
Because the enemy is trying to put us in our flesh.
Yes.
And we have to begin to stay in the spirit, stay with God, to move where we can hear from God.
Amen.
Put in situation, bills, buddies, children, silence on the enemy comes to what? Distract us, to move us. But one thing Hezekiah did, he kept crying out to God.
Amen. Yes, he did.
Look at 2 Kings 19 and 16 verses say, Lord, bow down thy ear. Look at Hezekiah saying, Lord, bow down thy ear and hear. Open, Lord, thine eyes and see. And hear the words of what Sennacherib, which has sent him to reproach the living God. Hezekiah said, Lord, look at this, what he sent me. He'll see these words that he has sent me this letter. Look, God, here it is, Hezekiah. Keep going, God. Said, look at this bullet. He keeps putting me, God. He keeps saying, what are you going to do to me? But God, you already sent word through your prophet. I bet you was going to release a word to him to cause him to leave me alone, God.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
Look at this. 2 Kings 19 and 20. Then Isaiah, the son of Amaziah, said to Hezekiah, said, thus said the Lord, the God of Israel, that which thou hast prayed Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless him, for he is God.
Amen.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Glory to God. So we see here in the 35th verse, no matter what Hezekiah was going through, in the 35th verse, it says, and it came to pass that night that the angel of the Lord went out and smote in the camp of the Assyrians, and 185,000. And when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses. So the secret king of the Assyria departed and went and returned and dwelt in what? Nineveh. Didn't he get the word?
Amen.
They said the king gonna go back. Just what the word of the Lord came to Hezekiah is the same thing that manifested.
Amen.
The king got spooked and left and went on. All that bullying, all that lie talking, all that bullying that he was doing to Hezekiah, he got spooked and got up and went back home. Is that not what Isaiah told him? Is that not what God had said was going to happen?
It happened.
He had to what? Be still. He had to what? Be still. He had to know his God. You got to know your God tonight. You got to believe in what he's saying, that he is God, that even in the midst of trouble, even when it don't look good, I will trust in the name of the Lord. Even when that son and daughter look like it's getting worse, I don't know about you, but I got some situations that look like it keep getting worse, but I stand on the word of God. I choose to trust God.
Amen.
That God gonna handle it. Why? Because he already told me he would handle it.
Yeah.
And look at here. Hallelujah. Not only did that king go back to where he was from, he died by his own son's hand. My God. Isn't that what the prophet had said? That king was going to go to pay it, that he was going to go down. And he went down just like God said. So tonight, you got to trust God. You got to believe God tonight that no matter what the situation is, you got to be still and know. I want you to look at, amen, Psalms 46, if that be your scripture for the week, amen, that particular Psalms, that division of Psalms, the 46th division of Psalms, and begin to read that, and let it get in your spirit, and begin to see what God keeps saying. God is. God is. What is he? He is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. What is he? He's your Savior. He's your Deliverer. He's your Way Maker. He is God.
Yeah.
Stand on the word tonight.
Amen.
Know that God is God. Come on, son. You got to know it. You got to believe it. You got to confess it. Amen. You got to begin to declare it. You got to begin to decree it. Amen. You got to begin to stand in the face of God and stand on what God has said. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. How many of us are blessed tonight?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise.
Hallelujah.
He is God. He is God. He is God. He is God. Hallelujah. We bless him tonight.
Hallelujah.
For he is God. Come on, son. God is God. Hallelujah. And we bless him tonight. Oh, glory. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For he is God. And we give him praise. And we give you glory tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.